should write down oxides. All elements of group 14 mainly forms two types of oxides. That is monoxide and dioxide. CO and CO2. Mainly two types of oxides, monoxides and dioxides. Write down lead. Lead also forms an oxide of Pb3O4 type. This kind of oxide lead forms. Okay, it is actually considered to be the mixture of PbO and PbO2.
PbO2 and PbO.
Okay. You see, Fe3O4 thing we have discussed already. Can you tell me the
hormones of PbO and PbO?
Wait, wait a second. Can you tell me the oxidation state of iron here, of each iron atom?
One is plus 2, the other one is plus 3.
Plus 2 and plus 3. Right. Why is this so? Because this is F, exists in the form of FeO and then Fe2O3. Right. So it is actually the addition compound. FeO dot Fe2O3 is nothing but Fe3O.
So this one.
Yeah. It is not a salt, it is oxide. So this will be, I think it is 2PbO and PbO2 because only mono and dioxide it forms. Right? So MO and MO2 type. So it is 2PbO and PbO2 type. So if I ask you what is the oxidation state of each lead atom in this oxide, PB3O4? They haven't asked this kind of this question, but this one they have asked many times. But it is similar, right? So if I calculate oxidation state here, it is minus 2, so here it comes 8 by 3, which is the average value, right? But oxidation state of each lead atom is what? It's plus 2 here, and here it is. Right? Plus 2 and plus 4, so total is what? 2 into 2, plus 4, plus 4, 8. Divided by 3, 8 by 3 is the average, that's what we have. Okay, so in PB3O4, the oxidation state is plus 2 and plus 4, you must remember. Okay, next write down. As we go down the group, next line in this, as we go down the group, the acidic behavior of dioxides, decreases. Basic behavior increases. Right? The CO2
is acidic.
Most acidic. And the last one is what? PbO2 is basic in nature. Reason is same. You dissolve this in water, it can release H+. Okay? That's why it's behaves in acid. Okay, the charge density is high here, it cannot lose H+ in aqueous solution. Okay, that's why the basic difference is here. Write down, next line again, due to inert pair effect, the plus 2 oxidation state of lead is more stable than plus 4.
Just lead, not the other one?
See, it's relative. It is very strong in the last compound, last element. That's why you're talking about lead. But in that other also you can say it. Plus 2 is more stable than plus 4. And hence, lead with plus 4 oxidation is treated. Like this you write down. Pb4. Lead with plus 4 oxidation is treated. Behaves as a strong oxidizing agent. PbO2 plus H2SO4. What it forms?
PbSO4
plus H2O plus O2. Right? So PbSO4 plus H2O plus O2. H2O plus O2. You see the oxidation state here, it is plus 4 and here it is plus 2. Next, write down halite. Write down all these elements combines with halogen. All these elements combines with halogen and forms halides of MX4 type. Combines with halogen and forms halides of MX4 type. Okay. See, few reactions we have done. Carbon, there are many compounds, derivative of alkane halides. If you see, we have CH2, Cl2, dichloromethane, we have CHCl3, trichloromethane, which we also call it as chloroform. CHI3 is triiodomethane, that is iodoform, right? CCl4 is tetrachloromethane, okay, CCl4. So the most important compound in this we have, CHCl3 in organic chemistry also we see, iodoform test, chloroform test, CHCl3, CHI3 is also important. Okay, so we'll discuss these two compounds. So write down first CHI3, triiodomethane. CHI3, triiodomethane. It is prepared by iodoform reaction. Iodoform reaction. Mechanism we will not discuss here. We'll discuss that in organic chemistry. Okay. Iodoform reactions are those reactions. In this, the reagent we use is NaOH, sodium hydroxide, with I2. This is the reagent for iodoform reaction. Okay, and all those molecules which contain C double bond O, methyl keto group, C double bond O, CH3. This group, if it is present, then it can show positive iodoform test with NaOH I2. Positive iodoform test means what? This on reaction with NaOH I2, suppose we have CH3 here, it converts into CHI2. Iodoform forms in this reaction and hence it gives positive iodoform test. Okay, so what you have to memorize, the molecule which has methyl keto group present, even alcohol which on oxidation gives methyl keto, like for example, we know 2 degree alcohol on oxidation gives ketone. Suppose we have this reaction, this can also shows iodoform test, because this part, if it goes under oxidation, it forms CH3 C double bond O CH3, which converts into methyl keto, and hence it shows iodoform test. Examine this question, they ask many times, they'll give you 8 to 10 molecules in integer type and they'll ask you how many of these molecules shows positive iodoform test. Okay, so condition is what? Methyl keto. If you have 2 degree alcohol, that will also get oxidized into this, hence this also shows iodoform test, right? So reaction, you write down CH3, COCH3 with NaOH I2 gives CH3 I3 plus CH3 CONA. One more compound it forms, NaI, and then water, H2. Okay, so mechanism we'll discuss in organic chemistry. 4 moles of NaOH we use and 3 moles of I2 we use for this purpose. 4 moles of NaOH and 3 moles of I2. Okay, so this is the preparation method of iodoform reaction. Okay, next write down chloroform. Write down, it is obtained by chlorination of methane. What is the reaction? Chlorination of methane? No, the mechanism? Free radical, right? Write down chlorination of methane this reaction we have already discussed. CH4 plus Cl2 gives CHCl3 plus HCl. Okay, one is chlorination of methane, second one. Plus HCl. Second method of preparation, it is obtained from the the reaction of chloral with chloral, ChLoRal, chloral with CaOH whole twice, calcium hydroxide. Chloral is this molecule, CHOCl3. This is chloral. Okay? We'll take two molecules of this, CHOCl3, and this is hydrolyzed with CaOH whole twice. Okay? The product here we get is, see, this H and this CCl3 combines, we'll get two molecules of CHCl3 and we'll get a result of this CaOC double bond OH. Next slide down. Electrode of carbon. Right on. The phenomenon by which an element exists in two or more different crystalline or amorphous form, two or more different crystalline or amorphous form are called allotropic forms or allotropes. Sorry, what is like the first thing? Phenomenon. Okay. Are called allotropy. And these different forms are allotropes or allotropic forms. Okay. And these different forms are called allotropy. And these different forms are allotropes or allotropic forms. Okay. Carbon, how many different allotropes we have for carbon?
Three crystals.
Diamond. Graphite and this two, you know, what is the, like, 2-3 points you should go into this one. What is the hybridization of carbon and diamond? Graphite. Arrangement, here we have tetrahedral and here we have layered structure, right? Layered structure. Each carbon atom is sp2 hybridized. Okay, which one is behaves as a conductor? Graphite. Okay, this property is zero. You should know the properties of this, because sometimes in the exam they ask this question also. Like properties, 3-4 options they'll write down. You have to choose the right one or wrong one. Okay, you should know the property. Next one, you write down. Okay, write down the chemical properties of this thing, carbon. Chemical properties. First point to write down, combustion. It shows combustion reaction, all allotropic form, right? Energy releases, exothermic, always exothermic, energy releases. In limited supply of air, what it forms? Monoxide. In excess of air, it forms dioxide. Next one. Carbon behaves as a reducing agent. Behaves as a reducing agent. It reduces many metallic oxides. Reduces many metallic oxides into corresponding metals. One reaction we write down, PbO plus carbon C gives Pb plus CO, carbon monoxide. H2O plus carbon, red heat, what it forms? H2O plus C.
CO
plus H2. CO plus H2, what we call it as?
Water gas.
Water gas, syn gas, synthesis gas, all are same, right? So this reaction is H2O plus carbon gives you. What is producer gas?
CO plus N2.
CO plus N2. Okay, this also you remember. CO plus N2.